First thing I want to do is take a drill that Dan did, that you've all probably done, and just show you how we can turn it into something that's much more realistic to the game. The big terms we talk about now is, do the drills you do transfer to the game, and does what the athletes do get retained? Transfer and retention are the two big buzzwords in motor learning. And that's one of the biggest things I think we've done with our senior basketball, or with our women's high performance, is constantly are analyzing our drills to make sure that they transfer and get retained. Now again, I'm gonna have to warm these guys up, so I'm gonna show you another way that I use to warm up. And again, I'm hide a lot of things in the spaghetti sauce, I call it. Okay, so you gotta make it a little fun. So here's what we're gonna do. Let's get everybody up in the center circle. Let's go. Now, one of the questions they asked me was, Coach, are we gonna get to shoot? Yeah, we're gonna do a little, we call this IPP, Individual Performance Plan. That's an IPP for us. We're gonna get them warming up during their IPP. So guys, here's what we're doing at first. We're gonna work on dribbling up the court. We've got an outside lane. Who can tell me what the outside lane is? This is a knowledge question. It's outside the volleyball, so it's from the sideline of the volleyball. That would be the left lane going that way. The alley is right down. The swing spots are in line with the foul lane extended. We got the center lane, the right alley, and the right lane. So you're dribbling up the court in an alley, and you're going to make an imaginary dribble move outside the three to go score a layup. When you score your layup, you can score at the front rim, you can do a side rim, or you can come under for a back rim. Can you dribble up the alley, do an imaginary move, and score a front rim layup at that basket? Here's the alley, right down here. Come down the alley. Come straight down the alley, make an imaginary move at the three-point line. Now do a front rim. Is that a front rim? Yeah, that's a front rim, my definition. He was going straight at the rim. A side rim is when you're going to use the side of your body, the width of your body, and score. Can you go out in the outside lane, do a dribble move, and then score me a side rim layup? What do you think? Is that a side rim? No, that was still a front rim. So a side rim is when you're going to cross the front and maybe a little baby hook over it. Or, coach, is a classic one is a baseline layup. Can I see a ball with your ball? So, guys, a front rim, anytime I'm going at the rim, this could be a side rim where I do a baseline layup here. Or I come over here, that's a side rim. A back rim where I'm coming to the back side of the rim. You understand? Now, this is a lot of guys for two baskets. So it's going to be real ugly, but that's okay. So you're just going up and down the court. We're not going 1,000 miles an hour. We're just getting our heart rates up. Using all the different lanes, different finishes. You gotta be aware who's at the rim. Safety. Don't go charging into everybody. Away we go, mix it up. So again, I'm just trying to get heart rates up. Just trying to get them warm. And you watch, they'll turn it into a pattern. See what they'll start doing it. I don't want a pattern. And stop, hold up. Guys, why are we just going in this big circle? We have a center lane, we have an alley, mix it up. Hesitate, sometimes if you see there's a bunch of people at the rim, hesitate out here. Coach Torbert this morning, maybe I'm gonna do a dribble, pretend I'm doing a dribble at, and then I'm gonna play. Okay, so you have to have vision and see what's going on. Away we go. So that was some teaching. I'm trying to help them with some of the things they're doing. It's going to be hard with this group to do a lot of error detection correction right now. And I'm not in warm-up. I'm not doing a lot of that. I'm just trying to get heart rates up. And stop. Now you've got to pretend you're doing your dribble move. And DeAndre Jordan, you're playing the U.S. men's team in the Olympics, and DeAndre Jordan is protecting the rim. What do you think you're going to have to do? Float? No, I don't want to see a floater. I want to see a pull-up. I think I told you yesterday, a floater is the last one I teach, because a floater is a reason for a bad shot. Yeah, coach, I'll shoot my floater. I don't want to see the floater right now. I want to see the pull-up. We'll get to the floater later on in the year, but right now we're doing our pull-up. You see DeAndre, do your pull-up. Way you go. I'll be honest, if I said DeAndre Jordan to my 14-year-old girls, they wouldn't have a clue. So I can't use that with guys. I can use that a lot more. Doesn't mean I don't try with the girls to get them to understand WNBA players. But if I said DeAndre Jordan, they'd be like, who's that, coach? LeBron, they do know. They do know LeBron. And stop. So again, that's just working on getting heart rates up. We're simulating coming down the floor, making a dribble move. Now we're going to simulate playing one-on-one off a blast cut. Your name is? Jose, can you go in the corner? Yeah, need a ball. So guys, we're going to use, for simplicity's sake, we're going to use the spots that Coach Torba had, just for simplicity. We got corner, wing, top, wing, corners. Everybody understand the five spots? You're going to do a self-toss from one spot to the other. Do a self-toss. And on this toss, we're going to give him, for now, two choices. You could cross over, or you could attack middle on the curl. You got your front rim, you got your side rim, or you got your back rim finish. Okay? The next time you go, you got to go to that. No, we'll keep it one end. We'll keep half and half, guys, but you got to go to a new spot. Give us one demo. Okay, so we got to work on our travel. So we want to catch that, cross, pivot, and cross. Okay, so he's working on his crossover or curl. Half there, half there. Heads up, pay attention who's around you. So now we're working more one-on-one, just getting warmed up again on their crossovers and curls. Mix up your finishes. And stop. Now, here's my rule. So I'm going to start loading in some things. Cannot take off inside the smile. You cannot take off inside the smile. Every layup has got to be outside for an extension, a little baby hook on it, but you cannot have a foot inside the smile. Does everybody know what the smile is? And coaches, if I didn't have a smile in my gym, I would be taping it down or painting it in. It is one of the best teaching tools there is in the game for spacing. I have a little thing with a cord, and every gym I go into, when I train, I just have it. I can measure the smile, and I can measure the three-point line. So if it's not there, at least we can have something to put some spots down for it, so we know. It's a very good teaching tool. Where we go? Keep going. Nothing inside the smile. Good. Extend. Okay, you can start adding your pull-ups now, too. You can add your pull-ups. And stop. Now, this time. What are you doing? Right here. Start over in that wing, and you're going to toss to the top. Now we're simulating toss. That the defender was in perfect defensive position, and this person is a lockdown defender, and this person has been taught to put ball pressure. What have you been taught to do when you face, you're parallel to me and you face good ball pressure? What have you been taught to do? What have you been taught to do? Oh, see, look what I'm starting to make him do. Because he doesn't want, look what he's doing. Are you in a good position right now to play?
No.
No, you've got we call it a space pivot. Have you been taught a space pivot? Coach, has coach taught you space pivot yet? Okay, real quick. You ready to get a partner? Real quick, get a partner. Go stand by your partner. Real quick, quick, quick. Hurry up. Stay right here. You're my partner. You come here too. Now, set one ball down in a safe area. This is how I teach a space pivot, coaches. You're going to hold the ball like that. Guys, see how one guy holds it like this. The other guy's going to hold it like this. No, I get to be the guy first. You hold it like that. Okay? The person holding like this is the one who's going to do the space pivot. Now, what a space pivot is, it's the same thing yesterday, Coach, when I showed about a take-on and brace. I must get perpendicular to pressure. I must be perpendicular. So what I'm going to do is I'm actually going to demo. You hold on to the ball. What did I do to get the ball from you? I ripped it, but I also jumped. Why? I'm putting all of my weight on. Now, I wouldn't actually do that again, but I want to get on top of the ball to put my weight. If I try to pull the ball, what happens to me? Even if I get it, I'm off balance. So I want to make sure when I get the ball, I'm in a perpendicular position, I'm looking through you, and I'm protected space. That's a space pivot. Okay? So just try it with your partner right now. I'm just showing you this because I think it's one of the most important things in the game. Space pivot. Then just switch it up. Who's doing the space pivot? Good. Just switch it up. Don't have to jump. I just showed that to get my weight, but get your weight on top of the ball. Just pull down. Push down on the ball. Okay. Back to our original drill. You're doing, I'll demo. I'm doing my self toss. I've caught it. Good defense is on me. I got a space pivot. I'm looking for somebody. I'm not open. Now I'm going to start with a dribble center. Remember dribble coach Talbot or Torbett? And off this dribble center, I sense that the guy's either not giving, he's not in good defense. I can turn the corner or I can cross back. You understand what I mean? Do your self toss. Space pivot. No one's open. Now start your dribble center. Dribble center. Oh, you're going around the three-point line. Around the three-point line. And then all of a sudden, if I overplayed, cross over and attack. Coaches, you understand what I'm trying to get them to work on? Okay? So they're learning to play off their space pivot dribble center. Because in Rick's offense and our offense too, dribble centers are big. We call them dribble centers. What did he call them? Dribble ats. The reason we call them dribble centers, we don't like to do dribble ats out to the sides. We don't want most of our dribble ats going to the middle, not to the sides. It's not an absolute rule. Okay, way you go. Work on your dribble centers. Space pivot, dribble center. Then play off the dribble center. On your own, on your own, on your own. Adam, is that my time? 37 minutes? Oh, whoo! I was going to say, I'd be like, okay, I'm on the defensive thing. And stop. Okay? So coaches, all I'm trying to give you is we played one-on-one off the dribble. We played one-on-one off the catch. Now I'm just going to show, I'm not going to do this with everybody. The other way we would play one-on-one, I'll get you down here, is he's going to pretend he's playing one-on-one off the pivot. And he's pretended that he's did his cut to the rim and he sealed somebody right at the rim. And you're going to pretend you get your pass and now with no dribbling, you've got to score from right here. Okay? Now, a couple points. First of all, we're still going to top with a self-toss. I can self-toss to a high one or I can self-toss to a bounce pass. The only rule, guys, for this one is this. I'm going to get the ball like Coach said up here, but when I pivot, I must be looking under the ball on my pivot because I need to shoot quickly. I can't play with it down here. So no matter which way I go, when I'm here, I'm under the ball. Now I can still play from here and fake, but I gotta be under the ball. Can you try one of those? Play off a pivot. Yep, and you shoot, you're gonna score it. See how I went down? Okay, don't go down, go again. Play off the pivot. Good. Finish it. Okay, so we would just be playing off the pivot at the baskets too. So we worked on off a pivot, off a dribble, off a catch. Does that make sense? As we got into practice, I'd start loading in defense. But this is just warm up. You guys kind of warm now? Get yourself in a group of three, one ball. Group of three, one ball. Guy with the ball along the volleyball line here. Another guy here, and a guy on the other volleyball line. So we need two guys here, with one with the ball over there. We're doing XOX passing. Groups of three. Figure it out, guys. Three is like one, two, three. Make a group of four then. Make a four. And I need the guy with the ball right here. And the second guy behind. And the third guy in the other volleyball line. This is like Sesame Street. One of these things is not like the other. In fact, it's like five of these things are not like the other. Now, this was my team. Remember I talked yesterday about culture and addressing things in the moment? We'll be solving this one right now. This is more important than the drill to solve this sort of stuff. That there's a certain way we have to practice. There's a certain way we have to get the work team. I don't have time to do that today. Okay? But that's important that you address things of the culture of how you're going to do things. It's much more important. Much more important. Okay? So they have to learn to lead themselves, but what we're having trouble with now is there's no followers either. Okay? So, you guys down there, where's your group of three? You guys just move up this way, son. Yeah. Come up. Everybody get in where they're in the volleyball lines. So this is one of the oldest drills in the game. It's just pass and replace. You're going to pass. Where's your partner? There. Pass. Run to the right side of him. Run to the right. Once you get past the last guy, do a jump stop. Nope, the last guy in the line. Jump stop and pivot. Now see, this is bad coaching. I'm doing this on purpose. I'm talking to him. I should talk my demonstration. There's a big difference. That was bad. Now we'll do it here. Here's what you're going to do. I'm going to pass the ball. I'm going to run to the right, go past the person, jump, stop, pivot should put me right behind him. Was that easier if I had shown you than just told you? But how many times do we give bad instructions as coaches? All the time. Talk your demonstration. It's one of the best things you can learn to do. Ready, go. Let's see how they do. I'm sure you've done this drill somewhere in your life. And I'm just going to keep building this drill to show you. And stop. Now guys, we got to pay attention to the little details. First thing is, you must shorten your pass. You need to step, and we're passing with one hand. We're passing right hand, shorten the pass. Same foot, same hand. Receiver, you must hop, little crow hop to receive it. Go, here we go. Crow hop, little short pass. Short, same foot, same hand. Same foot, same hand. Same foot, same hand. And stop. I'm loading fast here. Now you gotta call the guy's name. Gotta call the guy's name. Play, here we go. Call the guy's name. Here we go. Call the guy's name. And stop. Now I'm going really fast. And somebody's gonna say, well, this is an on-air drill. There's still a place, as we've heard, for on-air drills. It'd be nice if we could do all games approach, but there's a reason why you can't teach just through the game. Because they may not get the reps and the skills they need to develop those fine motor skills. But you can't stay at this forever. This gets boring, right guys? We want to get to playing. So we got to start slowly turning this into more game-like. First thing we're going to do is this. Make your pass. Mow over. Next guy in line, you've got to go and touch the sideline first. Now, when are you going to pass to him? When he gets the volleyball and he shows his hands. All right? So pass. Next guy in line. You got to go that way first. You got to go opposite first. Show your hands. Way you go. You got to go away from the ball first. Receiver's got to go away, come back. Way you go. Go. Timing of the pass. Good timing of your pass. Go away first. Go away. You didn't go away. You got to go away. Go away first. And stop. There's all kinds of things to load in. Now we're going to just load in the dribble. Bounce it up. You bounce it up. Make your pass. Pass. So you're going to dribble. Dribble. Jump stop. cross over, step and pass. Travel. Stop, cross over, left hand. That's now your left hand. Okay? Whichever hand you pass with, that's the way you run. Run to the end line. You got to catch, dribble, jump, stop, cross over, pass. Good. Go to the end of the line. Dribble, jump, stop, cross over, pass. Away we go. So again, they need some reps just in that skill. And that's the purpose of On Air. I'm working on form and speed. That's all I'm trying to get. Get some form, then get some speed. And stop. Now we're going to load in the defense. Pass, run over, and now you're playing. Let's shorten this up for now. Let's come up, bring our line up to about here. Just we'll shorten. You guys stay in that white line. Now we're tracing the ball, just like Coach Kirby taught us. Trace the ball. You've got to work on finding the windows. You've got to show your hands. Make your pass. Now you go, defense, end of the line. XOXO passing. Way you go. Put the defense in there. Here we go. Find the windows. So again, now we're more guided, more of a phase, what we call phase B drill with a guided defender. And stop. Now, I don't have time to do all the teaching points, but I'll just give you a couple of them. Come on, we'll play defense here. You go back to the end line. Now, number one rule for me is you must enlarge the space. So if his hands are up, where's the open window to pass? So where do you want to fake? Up. Why? It makes his hands go even higher. If his hands are down, where's the space? So where do you want to fake? How big a fake do you want to make? Now, you guys, do you have to sell this with a big arm movement? What's the problem if you do this? Before you can pass, what does he have to do? He's got to bring it back up. Coach Torbert taught us this yesterday. It's very important. I want to be already loaded my spring, and I'm here. Now, if your hand, there's where your hands are going to be, all I got to do is twitch. Ooh. That's all I've got to do. If his arms are up, I just got to twitch and then pass. If your players learn this, it becomes really easy to pass. If they're doing this, they can never pass. We don't want to be out there cha-cha-cha. Okay? Just twitch, pass. Find the window. Way you go. You got to work this one. Hold. Freeze. See, I got to solve this. You caught the ball and you're standing like this. I got to catch it. As soon as I catch it, boom. Springs loaded. As soon as you catch it, load the springs. Play. Here we go. Load the spring right away. Load the spring. One air pass. That's a good air pass right there. And freeze. Guys, you're not understanding. I'm fussy. This is a loaded spring. This is not loaded. Because before I pass, I got to do this. Boom. I'm already here. Bang. Load your spring. Get this elbow facing forward. Twist. Boom. Now, if I have to pass it through the other side, though, then I'm just going to twist and pass the other side. Play. Here we go. Very important they work on that skill. And stop. Now, we now are going to move this along. We need more space. You guys are going to work right over here. Come on over here. In this space right here. Going that way. Set it up. You guys are right in the middle space right here. You guys are in that lane right there. Okay, you, your group in that lane. You guys in the middle right here. And you guys are down in there. Okay, now, here's how we're setting it up now. You guys have from sideline to middle of the key. Sideline, middle of the key. Ball's here, set it up the exact same way. Another guy behind, two guys down there. Two guys down there. This is called break the three in a row. Break the three in a row. Okay, so you're on defense, offense. A three in a row is you're directly behind his back. Come on in the middle here. You have got to go to a space where it's no longer three in a row. Ball, man, you. Here or here. Go ahead. Pivot. Break the three in a row. You got to move. You got to move. Whoa, whoa, whoa. Move and also shorten the pass. Boom, boom. Shorten the pass. Here we go. Good. Now, who's now the defender? Go guard him. See, naturally, we're in a three in a row. You've got to now break the three in a row. Where can you cut to? Good. Break the three in a row. Break. Oh, no, no, no. You didn't break the three in a row. You've got to create an angle for this pass. See, that's what happens. The person without the ball just stands and says, well, I'm open. Yes, but we have to pass through a defender. You have to learn how to make an angle. When we start passing the posts, angles become important. So we're going to do this in a group of three. Where's my extra guy? Come out here. Where's my extra guy? Come in here. Where's a group of four? Where's my other group of four? You two are just in a group of four? Okay, you're a group of three. Way you go. Get going. Pass and replace. Where's your group of three? Guys, that's a group of four, isn't it? No, you're three. And three. You're three. You come right in here. Right in here. You guys are down there. Good. Okay? Let them go for about 10. Go ahead. Get going. Pass, replace, break the three. Let them go. Where was your group again? Let them go for just about 3 or 4 and then sub in. Let them go for about 3 or 4 times and just sub in. Okay? Break the three in a row. And stop. See, right now, in my younger days, my frustration level would be going like this. And I'm getting into my emotional brain. And as a more wise coach, I've learned, serenity now. Okay? I have to calm myself down. I cannot get frustrated. I have to do my mental training right now. Okay? And I'm saying, why can't they do this? Why are they not getting this? And then I start to yell and scream, and that's not going to solve it. I have to understand it's probably my bad instructions. And I have to make sure they have a clear picture in their mind. I know the drill. I've seen it 1,000 times. They may never have seen it, and they may not clearly understand. Set up here. Everybody watch. Are you in a three in a row right now? Go somewhere where you're no longer in three in a row. Okay, freeze. Now, what else should he do to let him know he's open? Call his name and show us a target hand. Okay, go. Who's on defense? Go sprint. Now, you got to go somewhere. Excellent. Good. Get on defense. Good. Whoa, that's right. Now, where does the passer want to fake now? Fake opposite where he's going to be. Fake. Way you go. Break your three in a row. Sub will sub in after about 3 or 4 times. And stop. Now, I'm only going to do it on this side of the floor for now. Give me 4 guys in a group. Right here. Remember a group of 4 right here. Start at the basket with the ball. Guard him. You stay right here as an outlet. You go down at that end. You guys just move off the court for a second. I'm now making this more game-like. Same drill, make it more game-like. Toss the ball. You're an outlet person. Now, as soon as he gets it, you're guarding here. Nope, defender, you're guarding here. Guard him. You get the ball. Get the ball. Now, you've got to dribble. He's got to pass to you. Now, start to dribble. You're defending him. Defend him. Real game. Now, freeze, freeze. You're defending him at that basket. Get in front of him. Now, you've got to create the angle. If he was dribbling more in here, we're going at that basket. You've got to cut out to the lane out there. Look back up a little bit. There. Make the pass. Give and go. Cut. You get it back to score. Now, defender, who scored on offense? You're now defending him. No, you rebound it. You rebound it. You're defending him. You've got to be the guy ready to cut. Pass it in. Get it up the floor. Freeze. That's right. If he's taking it up the sideline, where's the angle for you to break the three in a row? You've got to go more in there. Pass it to him. Give it go. Who's on D? Offense is on D, 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 D. Oh, you've got to guard him. Go, you'll be ready to catch. Whoa, freeze, freeze. Where's your angle? He's dribbling up the side. Where's your angle? And cut to the ball, guys. Cut to the ball. Don't slide sideways. Shorten your pass. Run to the ball. Shorten your pass. Play. Here we go. Yeah, get it to him. Give and go. Give and go. Whoa, whoa, whoa. You can't dribble. You've got to give him a give and go. You've got to sprint to your cut. You've got to be ready to snap it back. Now, if he doesn't get it, you've got to come down and then get open. And play. Play your one-on-one. You get ready for the outlet. Who's on D? Who's on D? Who's on D? Get it to him. Get it to him. And freeze, freeze. Coach, you see the drill? I don't have time to do it with everybody, but that's how we start to turn that same kind of XOXO into a realistic game. Now, in my gym, what I do when we train with my little girls is we go on the two cross courts, four that way, that's eight, right, 12. I kind of go like cross courts like that. Or I can go when I rotate them out, or let them go, okay? So it's a great drill to teach passing angles. Now, go back into your groups of three again, or four, and we're gonna do it a little different this time. I'll demo with you guys. Start with the ball down there. You guard him. I'll do it for the group of three. So I need a sub right now. You be my sub for a second. So defense is now here on the receiver. Defense is on the receiver. So now we're working on passing to a sealed player, a posted player, somebody getting a pass for an inbound, posting up to get an entry pass on a wing. So we worked on this yesterday with the girls. When I seal guys, I want to put my hip, my scapula, my shoulder blade, and my tricep on the person. Are you going to defend me? And then if he moves, I box him out. I'm open. Right? That's what I'm doing. Now, I was just on offense. Defense, go post up on him. Go post on him. You defend him. Seal. Seal. I may have to make an angle to make the pass. I may have to make an angle. See what I did, guys? I had to dribble. Now, you come and seal on me. Well, I'm not going to let you seal it. Okay? So I'm allowed to dance around and not get sealed. You got to try to seal me. Do you see how the drill I did yesterday for warm-up? The take on, the brace. He didn't try to take me on. What did you? Let's go slow. Come to try to seal me. See, he's coming at me skinny. Go again. He's coming at me. Give me that elbow again. And now I'm defending. I'm on defense. Come at me again, skinny. What are you gonna do? Come and box like you're taking me on like this, like you're setting a screen. Now, seal. Good. Don't come skinny. Come in like you're setting a screen on the guy. Give it a try. Everybody has to learn how to seal and to receive a pass from a seal. Get it to him. Good. Switch it. Go seal him. Seal him. You just sub in. Groups of four. Get going, guys. Come on. You're wasting time. And stop. See, here's my frustration level going again. They've had eight reps. You've had zero. Okay, so one of my favorite movies is John Wayne Cowboys, and it says, we're burning daylight. You're burning daylight. We need to get reps. Did you not understand the drill? Yes, you didn't understand it, you do understand it. So again, it's helping players learn how to practice. And in me, that's more important than the drill early in the season. I am not compromising that we're gonna waste time. I'm not gonna punish them, but I want them to be aware we're wasting time, and you have to work on that. Don't compromise your culture and address it in the moment. Okay, guys, you understand? I'm not mad at you. I want you to get your reps going. Get it organized. Let's go. Here we go. Work on the seal. And stop. Coaches, you get the idea? Okay, so we have to work that. Now let's make it more realistic. Ball's here in the swing spot, right here. Wing. We'll see your transfer, Coach Torbett stuff. I want you to dribble at him. Dribble at? What's your rule on dribble at? Go hard to where? Try to take him deeper. Take him right to the smile. And now post up. Pass. Now, if you have a good seal and you think you can score, remember the first little thing I showed? He's working on a score from down there. If you don't, what are you supposed to do? Excellent. Help your teammate out. Okay? So he can go for the Lakers. Because remember, this is still XOXO passing. Think about this. Is this not XOXO passing? Defender? That's exactly XOXO passing. But we're just putting it into where it happens in the game. Let's watch them live once before you guys go. Now, we'll have to take turns at the basket, right? So we're not. Let's watch them here once. Dribble at. Now, very important, and Coach Torbett, I love this. This is one of the best things I've learned. Whose turn was it to score first, guys? Yours. You never. You just didn't even look for your turn. Our rule for our teams are, if you catch it this deep in the paint, it's always your turn. It is your turn every single time. Because the foul is just as important as the basket. Get this guy in foul trouble. If you catch it here, you have a quick turn if you can go quickly, then it's his turn, then it's your turn again. Way you go, guys. Give it a try. Dribble center, post up. Just be aware of the other teams. Nice. Did he do a dribble center? Where's our dribble center? Use your dribble. Start on the wing. Okay, let's start again. You're in the top. You go start in the top. You're on the wing. Guard him on the wing. Dribble center. Hard cut to the rim. Hard cut to the rim. Now post up. There you go. That's it. And stop. I'm moving quickly. You guys come over this side. I'll use you to demonstrate. You guys to switch sides. Just watch here, guys. Ball here. Post away. Post away. Opposite block. Who's on offense? Opposite block. Now here's what's going to happen. You're going to do your self-toss to that spot. Self-toss. Defenders. Oh, give me a good self-toss. Game speed. Game speed. Hurt. Now, defender. You are either going to be in shade left, where you're splitting him here, or you're going to be in shade right. You know what if I end up in the, what are you going to do in this one? Attack middle. What if I end up in shade left? Now see, right now, if this was my practice, I'd be concerned about these three guys down here. Because they don't think I saw them, but I did. And I'd be addressing that. I don't have time now, but they know I'm addressing it. Because I've always been taught if someone's talking, you stop and pay attention. So I'm going to wait for you guys to be done talking. Because you must have something important to say. Now I'm kind of joking with you, but I'm not. Guarantee you, if you ever come to a national team tryout, a provincial team tryout, or a tryout, and you pull that stuff, your name goes on the list. And it may not be true, the list. But you're giving an impression to people that you don't pay attention. All right? And it may not be true. But it's just because what I saw and what I heard makes me feel something. So again, as a coach, I'm very in tune to that stuff, and you've got to be too. And guys, you've got to be in tune to that. Coaches are making judgments about you, and they may not always be true, but you got to be careful because they're judging on what you say or what you do. Okay? So you got to learn to pay attention, even when it's boring stuff from an old guy. Okay, self-toss. Give us a read. Good. Now, freeze. We're now working on XOX passing here. I need your attention. Eyes and ears right here. If he dribbles center, We are circling. We're going under to make that space bigger. You either got the open rim or you got him. You're still coming in, okay? If he goes baseline, let's go back again. If he give him the read to go baseline, self-toss and go baseline. Show him the baseline. Go baseline. Go hard under. You're circling with him. You just, and this little pass right here is a really tough one to stop. That's probably one of the biggest things at the Olympics we saw, was people driving the highway, I call it. This is the highway. Driving this highway and bang, hitting somebody right there with that circle action. It is really tough because everybody turns and looks. Give me one live demonstration. They'll go, then you guys will go on the other side. There you go. Self-toss. Good. Play. That's XOXO passing. Give it a try. One group, then the other. Way you go. Way you go. Here we go. Quick, let's go. We're burning daylight. We're burning daylight. Let's go. We need a post pair over there. Quick, let's go. Post pair over there. Post pair, no ball. Quick, quick, quick. They're going first. Go. You guys go here. You guys go here. Give him a read. Give him a read. No, no, no. You guard him, and you give him a read. So I'll be you. Pass. He's going. You're circling. Good. Got it? Way you go. Run it right away. You guys are running it over there. And play. See, they're struggling because this is a lot, right? I mean, I'm going 1,000 miles an hour. So I know that. But I'm hoping you've got to manage yourself too and your emotions. And am I going too fast? Maybe I got to slow it down. I got to let them play ugly for a while. I've given way too much information. Let them play a little bit. Figure it out. Okay? I'm also would be watching. Who's the leaders out there? Okay? Who's the followers? Are my leaders good leaders or are they bad leaders? Are they taking energy from the group or are they giving energy? I gotta watch for that. Okay? Because my culture is my most important thing. We gotta have a culture of learning. We gotta have a culture of energy giving. Yourself toss. Here we go. Okay, freeze, freeze. Now, coaches, just so we see this, and guys, watch here. Set that one up exactly as we did. Give me another pair, offense, defense, right here. Just go slow. This is why I don't like you backing up. Go slow. Do the exact same thing. I'll be you on defense. Rotate, back up. At the Olympic level, at your club level, there's someone who will do that on defense, right? That savvy player who just rotates, because I know that 9 times out of 10, you're gonna pass where you're looking. And all I do, I'm a good defensive back in football, I read the quarterback's eyes. When we get to the disruptive defense, that's one of the most important things. Read the eyes of the ball handler. They will tell you where they're passing 9 times out of 10. Most people pass where they're looking. So that's why I want you to circle. You circle under. I can't run all the way over here and guard you. But you just have to know that the pass, that little diagonal pass or that little snapback pass is the most valuable pass to learn. And if we don't have you go there, he'll never learn that. Coaches, you understand that? When you can get players who can make these passes on the angles, that's when you get the home runs. The pass is straight ahead. Every kid sees that pass. They see it too much. They need to have, but if we don't get people in the angles, you're never gonna get that. You need to teach players to get in the angles. That's where the big money is. That little snapback that Kirby talked about, right? That pass, we call it a lift to the lift person. Very important, it's called the shape. Okay, guys, a couple more reps. Here we go, a couple more reps. And again, I would start loading in some extra people. But can you see how this is still just XOXO passing? So we're getting a pass off the dribble. That's all we're doing. We just keep loading it to make it more game-like. And stop. I'm going to give you one last one. Give me three on three. Can I get one guy to go white? One more guy to go white? Somebody else go white real quick. Give me a white shirt down here quick, real quick, just to show this one. So give me a top, a wing, and a corner, and three defenders, three reds on defense. Corner, please, corner. No, I'm going to keep you in the post. Keep you the ball offside post. Can you get that ball over there? Again, safety, coaches, always our number one concern is safety. So here's what we're going to do. We're playing three on three. You start down the corner. We're going to run a blast cut. We're going to run this cut. So you run your cut. This is XOXO pass. Can you make that pass? All you have to do in this is either give him, again, a baseline or a middle read. That's all I want you to do. You're going to start your cut, but you got to read the same thing that he's reading. Let's go back again. Can you exaggerate your read a little bit? So here comes the pass. Freeze. Which way do you think he's going to go? Middle? Then what do you think? You got to slide and make a double gap. You got to make space. Okay? What do you do? What do you do in a middle penetration? You should have been, as soon as he took that, you're going under. So we're really messing with the high eye and the low eye. We're trying to mess these guys up. Let's go slow and show it if it goes baseline. Give him the baseline read. Which way do you think? What do you do in Rick's offense? You pull. And you circle, that's right. Don't circle too high, because now another player can get you. It's more variable here. Okay, let's try it. We'll just do it with these guys, just for quick. I only got a couple minutes here. One dribble too many. One dribble too many. He was there a little sooner. And throw it high to this guy. Throw it up there. And that's, we throw too many soft bounce passes. We got to start throwing the ball up in the air. At the Olympics on the men's side, they don't throw any bounce passes at the rim. You just don't. You just throw it up top. Solves all the problems. And we have to start doing that in the girls' game too. Throw it up. Jump, land, put it back. Because you throw the soft bounce passes, they just come in there and they steal them. Or it forces me to go down here, and then I get low hand blocked. So start throwing it up there some. One more time, guys. One more time. That's it. That's better. That's a lot better. Put it down low, it's in trouble. Now, to progress this drill, just to show, if he was not open, let's say he blasts, he's not open, dribble at him. Freeze. Your post, you're a little different, you wait. Remember what Rick said, you can't cross this side of the floor. There's only one way you can cross the floor. Who remembers why when he can cross the floor? So who can screen? You set the screen for him. Now, this is XOXO passing. Here comes the guy off the screen. You face up here. Now, you got to read. Is it him or him? Okay? Or is it going to be you if he cheats too much? Let's try that one. We'll do a dribble center cross screen. So I'm just trying to show you how you keep layering it up to make it more game-like. Here we go. Play. Just play basketball. Play basketball. You guys give it a try down here. Three on three. Give it a try. Here we go. We got 3 minutes. 3 minutes. You guys are subs. Call names and sub in. Set it up. We're doing a dribble center. Yep. Here we go. Dribble center cross screen. Whoa, 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 whoa. Remember my... Hold up, guys. Time. Guys. Time. Transfer and retention. Coach Kirby just taught you about screening. Did he not just teach us screening? Did he? Yes. So what did he say the guy receiving the screen should do first? Show your hands. Let's set it up here again. You got to show your hand. Wait. Here we go. He dribbles over. Freeze. Pretend you cheat. You know the screen's coming. No, you wait. You're getting screened. If he comes way over here, what do you think we can do? We're just throwing it up there to you. As soon as you do this, he has a tendency to come to you. Now we get a better screen. Come headhunt, split his foot. Now use your screen, and you face up her. If they switch, we got the same little post up that we talked about at the first. Okay, so we need to have transfer. Way we go. A couple more reps. I'm talking way too much, but that's for you guys. I would let them play a lot more. That's too many interventions on my part. But I want you to get that information. Play. Yeah, good. And stop. Coaches, any questions on that? Did you get what I was trying to show you? How you take a simple drill we do at the elementary level and we just keep loading it up, but trying to make it game-like. And we hope that we get transfer. We hope that what they did in the very first drill transfers. It will never happen that fast. Never happen that fast. But over the course of time, they would get that. I'm doing this with my 14-year-old girls. They're getting not too bad at this. Is it perfect? No. But they're starting to understand, oh, I have to find windows to pass. Right? They're starting to understand about, oh, I got to seal properly to get the pass in. So it takes time, but you just have to stay with it and it'll get there. And don't go as fast as I did. Okay, guys, have a seat over here. Have a seat, quick. Now, we're going to look at disruptive defense. So, guys, get yourself organized into two teams. Red, and we got pennies there, Adam? Maybe we should get three teams. Organize whoever your leaders is. I want three even teams. And get pennies there. You guys organize that. Figure it out. Now, disruptive defense. Again, in my job, I have to define things so we can measure it. And all I did is I took my term of PVAD. And if you've been around me enough, you know PVAD is probably one of the most important concepts in the game. And PVAD is your positioning. That could be your head, your positioning of the ball when you're holding it, and the positioning where you are on the floor in relation to something. So your positioning improves your vision, your V. V. The vision. Your vision improves your ability to anticipate, like Kirby talked about. Basketball is a game of vision and anticipation. So I need to be in good position so I can anticipate, or have vision to anticipate my decision, the D. It's one of those things I wish I had known when I first started coaching, because it mostly starts with somebody being in a bad position. And when they're in a bad position, they don't know what to look at or they can't see it. And when they can't see it, they're going to anticipate the wrong thing, therefore a bad decision. Okay, so flip that around. Disruptive defense, the number one thing disruptive defense tries to do is take away what? Take away position. I'm going to disrupt you from being in the position that you want to be. One down here. And Pastor, come on down here. Just you guys stay there. Just you two for now. You go on the wing. And let's say you want to make a cut to the basket to post up. Let's say you passed. So I'm going to disrupt you. Pass. Start your cut. Boom. Coaches, is that legal? Am I legally allowed to get in this space and take him on? Yes. Did I disrupt your cut? Yeah. Now what do you have to do? And now I've disrupted the timing. I've disrupted a lot of things. So I am allowed to disrupt. Okay. Ball at the top. You take the ball at the top. You're down here. Notice I'm taking the small guy, because he'd kill me. I know. Okay, I know he wants the blast cut there. I know he just wants to cut to that. Here's what a lot of teams did at the Olympics, Serbia especially. They do what's called top lock. Everybody thinks the defense plays like this. Here's what Serbia did. Cut to get open up there. Australia scored 10 points in a half, in a semifinals for the Olympic gold medal. 10 points. And one of the main things was, Serbia just said, you are not getting to the positions you want to get to. I've never seen a better defensive performance in my life from a team of five players on the floor. Just say, you cannot get position. We are going to take away wherever you want to go. We're not letting you go there by putting our bodies in that position. That is totally disruptive. Does that make sense? Okay. Now somebody said, well, why don't you just go back door? Well, because of the next thing they did was they took away vision. And what Serbia did so well, and this is the most disruptive thing you can do, is ball pressure. It is the most disruptive thing you can do on defense, is to disrupt the vision of the person. And they just did that. Now see, right away, what did I make him do? He had to go to a space pivot. Do you say space pivot again? Where was his head? That wasn't where it was. It was where? Why is that bad? What's it taking away? Your vision. Can you anticipate open cutters? No, you can't. So you have to learn. Show me the good space pivot. Where's your head have to be? Put it right on the shoulder and look through me. Get down low. Look through me. Can you now see the basket and everything? Can you see as much as if you were in this position? No. So even though he goes to a good space pivot, he still doesn't have as good a vision if I just let him stand there and, as Kirby said, play darts. I do not understand why you would ever not play with ball pressure. Yeah, but coach, he's just going to blow by me. He's so much quicker. Yes, but if I make him go in a circle action, we have time to recover on that. Okay? But by playing like this, I don't think you're really disrupting the offense. And the number one thing I think you have to understand is this. You need, as I said, about 6 uncontested layups from your defense a game, minimum, to win. Right? You need about 6. Because the game is won by the team that makes the most uncontested layups. It really, that's at the Olympic level, that's at the NBA level, little girls. Because it's the easiest shot in the game. And if all you're doing is playing pack line and sagging in and all this stuff, and you don't create any offense out of your defense, it gets real tough to score. Remember Rick told a story about the other team just ran back, had 5 people back? It's hard to score against 5-on-5 all the time. So we want ball pressure. Anticipation. Once the offense knows what you're doing, it's easier to anticipate. One of the problems we have in Canada is that we pride ourselves on, we play great man-to-man, and we always do it this way. Well, what happens is, over the course of a game, the offense starts to get into your rhythm, and they know exactly what you're doing. And at the end of the game, when they run a ball screen, and they say, oh, we know that they will always hedge, and they'll always tag off the single side. They don't have to anticipate it, and they know exactly what they're going to do in the most crucial part of the game to get the shots they want. But if you come down one time, it's a zone. They trap it. They mix it up. They can't anticipate anymore. And I think one of the things we've done on defense, we've gone with this perfect way to play defense, and you have to be able to disrupt. Okay?